Morning students. Hope you all are doing well. Please take care of yourself. The new topic is test blueprint. Yes. You all know we discussed the Bloom taxonomy. Under Bloom taxonomy, we discussed 6 level of thinking, sample questions for 6 level of thinking and the distribution of question across the different levels of thinking. Today we will start with new topic. The new topic is test blueprint. Under this topic we will discuss what is test blueprint. Why we have to use test blueprint, steps involved in designing the test blueprint. Well, what do you think is test blueprint? Let me give you one example. Before we construct a house, we need to design a map. So that the whole construction process is guided by the map. Similarly, before you prepare question paper or test for your students, you need to prepare a plan of action like a map in construction. This plan of action is known as test blueprint. In a simple, it is a tool which shows the structure of a test. Table of specification or test blueprint is also defined as a two-way classification of the items that will constitute the test. It usually includes the content areas along the left side of the table and the cognitive level along the right side of the table, across the first row of the table. Next we will discuss, why we have to design test blueprint before making question paper. Well, we have to design test blueprint because of the following reasons. We design test blueprint, to provide a rational and systematic basis for assigning weighting to topics or questions. This is important because if we don't have test blueprint, we may make more questions or items from some units and less questions from the other units. There will unequal distribution of questions across the units. So in order to have equal distribution of question, we need test blueprint which is of course a plan of action. Second reason is to promote fairness to students. For instance, if your questions are all from Unit 1, can you give a justice to students who studied all the units? Who really worked hard? No. That is why we need test blueprint. To make appropriate and meaningful decision. Decision includes how many questions from high-order thinking and how many questions from low-order thinking. Test blueprint will also ensures that all the learning objectives were measured in the test. It will also maintain the validity and objectivity. You all know what is validity and objectivity.